What is up, Rad Potential YouTube? The rally car is on the frame rack, but we didn't crash it. We actually just got our bumper bent by Heavy Toe at Snowdrift. So it was the night before the rally, and we're putting the rally car on the frame rack because, you know, we don't want this like lopsided mustache going on at the race, and it's causing my KC lights to be all cantankerously cattywampus up here. So, Body Shot Master Calvin, we're in his
Taj Mahal
here, and we're gonna straighten this bumper. So I don't know if these are like original Sibby bumpers or if the stickers were just put on here, but the car's got these sweet like 90s tubular bumpers made for the Lancer Colts, and we towed from here and it pulled it. Yeah. I mean, to fix it, it looks like the frame rail is reasonably straight, but I did see like there's a little bit of some stuff going on in there, but
it may have been previous as well.
Could have been previously impacted with something. But this car is pretty straight. I have a feeling that these are the original fenders, and they actually look pretty good. Yeah. So, what's the...
So, the plan is to try and pull here, and then try and push off the tower with a porta power.
Okay.
To, like, push that back, because this seems to just shift over.
Yep.
I mean, I could probably swing this, swing another tower around and pull if that doesn't work. But I'm actually probably better off pulling with both instead of trying to push just because it's round. I'm not going to be able to put a flat plate on it. But
yep.
We will see what we
Would you with. Think, like, you're going to be pulling from here probably?
Yeah.
Or would it be wiser to pull because you're going to pull this way, right?
Yeah.
And probably, you want to pull this way.
I would probably try and pull this
okay.
that way.
Okay.
Because I need, this is bent, so like it needs to bend back around
yeah.
here. So I need to just try and twist that.
Okay.
So
makes
if I
sense.
Can pull this and hold pressure and then take that and pull it to try and pull it back around.
Okay. And then I noticed too, when you like really stand back and you look at it,
it's down.
It's down.
A lot.
So, and it's kind of, this might just be that the light bar wasn't welded on perfectly centered. But the light bar itself, like this
yeah.
to here, like when it swings back over,
oh,
I
yeah.
guess.
It'll pull that back.
It over. Might pull because it, you know, I don't know. This has, yeah. didn't look like it slid on that.
Well,
because I bet that probably
bolt.
Held it.
I bet it just pivoted.
Yeah.
So,
because it looks like this part came forward, which gives yeah. the illusion that the light bar is offset to the right.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. Y'all kind of take a look. Move Calvin out of the way. But you can see like right here, where this is lined up almost with the corner of that headlight, and now this is very much so not. So I think like a combination of, you know, the over and the up, but it might have actually like pushed, you know, oh yeah, there's a little gap right there.
Yeah, it pushed.
So I think it pushed the whole thing over versus just twisting that side. Cool. Well, we're going to get the racks and jacks and all sorts of stuff chained set up and start pulling on this thing.
Pulling
in the fish. But it did drive all the way here, about 25 miles or so.
It's super like, awesome that the car was driven a week before.
I know. We didn't just get it started like 2 days before the rally. So I've got a little bit of a, I don't know if it's a driveline vibration or, well, I know it's a driveline vibration, but I don't know if it's a lack of my like eye-chrometer's calibration of lining up the pinion angle on this. So with the Safari suspension, I've got to make sure everything's going good. This is a new rear end and all of that, so we're going to change that. And then I think I've got my trans mount in a little bit of a bind, because I also, the things you don't see is, or won't really notice, like, unless you're just watching this video right now, is that I also moved the engine back in the chassis about an inch and a half from where it was before, so that I could fit a fan on the back side of the radiator. So this car has a 2-liter engine in it, which didn't come in this car. So this car would have had a 1600 or 1.6 liter engine. And it looked like the stock engine mounts for the 1.6 were just bolted to the 2-liter, which then put the 2-liter way too far forward because it's a different block itself. So I slid it back. Now we're close to the firewall. I had to cut the shifter hole a little bit bigger, but now my long arms, I can easily reach the shifter, which is a huge win. And now we have a hydraulic handbrake as well. hooked up to the stock handbrake from the other rally car. And then this is your big Datsun axle. Just hanging out. So it's all truss and stuff. You see the leaf springs are way bigger and the axle has these big braces underneath it.
You're gonna wanna anchor the car, right?
Let's see what it is.
Moving the car.
Yeah. Alright, we'll anchor it down.
Even my Hoosier slicks are too loose for the frame rack. Do you normally not have to, or sometimes you can just get away with
depends.
Just depends.
Depends on how hard something is going to be to move.
Sure.
But I was curious, so since we were pulling here and here,
if it would like counteract itself. I mean, it was moving a little bit, then you started moving the car.
Yeah.
I mean, that guy's Denali pulled this thing pretty hard. So that closes this one off?
Yep.
And then you're going to try to pull on that one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So basically it's one hydraulic pump that then pulls just only where you tell it.
Pulls pressure to it.
Okay.
And then it divides it wherever.
Okay. You might need something anchoring it that way.
I know. I just want that to... I want the bumper to move, so I don't want to pull off the bumper. I just have to hook on that front.
But you can't really grab that tow hook, but you could just grab the K-member and pull it in a different direction. The tow hook's like... It's a hook, not a loop.
Don't stand right behind this or this in the event that something snaps. Come back at you.
Man. Okay. That's... I mean, it's a wonder that Denali didn't rip this thing clean off.
Give me a second. I'm gonna get this close. But then open that.
Oh, you got a leak.
Yeah.
Okay, so you close that one, which is gonna hold the pressure here, right? Okay, and we're gonna open this one.
Yeah.
I'll just let you do it. That's going to release the pressure there.
Well, I'm just not releasing it.
Oh, until you hit the release button.
Yeah. I'm going to pull from this slot now. I don't think it's going to move from that spot.
Man. I mean, it moved a little bit, but...
I think I'm only going to move it from there.
I mean, it's already better than what it was. As always, you know, I don't know what the wall thickness is on that small tube in there.
Yeah.
We're not bending it, but...
I say that's why I wanted to be right at the weld.
For the sake of cracking the weld off. Versus, like, if we pulled from here this way, you know what I mean?
I just don't think it'll pivot like we need it to.
Sure.
You know, because we kind of need to pivot around that.
Yeah.
As opposed to on it.
Yep. Man, the thing is just moving. You aren't going to be able to tell at all that this thing even got bent now. So what are you looking at? Like, what's the icrometer of Calvin seeing here?
I'm trying to look down this to see, because that's where that bend was.
Yep.
Because it was bent around this, and it actually gave down here.
Okay.
So I don't have my flashlight on me, but you can see where the paint's cracked, right where the little tube and the big tube meet there.
Yep.
That's where it gave.
Okay.
So that's where it's going back at.
Okay.
So inevitably, we may end up having to brace that spot.
Okay.
Make it stronger there.
Sure. I mean, in a sense that we have to get flat-toed back to the pits again, but that's okay. We just need a not 2024 Denali with 700 diesel horsepower to yank our bumper off.
Smoother on it, but yeah.
I mean, it's... I wouldn't say it's like back, but... It's coming up too, which is cool. So there, and he released the pressure. It did go back just a little bit from where it was tensioned at. But here you can already see, I mean, if it was just, if we just pushed that side up just a tad, you wouldn't even really notice the difference there. No, we'll probably have to chain it to the thing down. Okay. Yeah.
No.
It's only 2,300 pounds.
It's only two bolts holding it in.
I know.
I'm surprised.
And you doubted me when I said just put the smaller bolts in there and nut it. The small bolts are good. There's only three of the four in there anyways. Or two of the three, maybe. I think it's three of four, right?
I think it's three of the four.
Yeah, it's There's three of the four.
The front.
Oh, dude, I need to take the old horns off. I don't know why I have the old horns still in here.
You got the old horns on. They don't even do anything anymore.
It's extra weight. You got the air horns in there.
That's extra weight.
Yeah, it is extra weight. We're going to be slower because we have the other horns on it. We got air horns now. It's just sliding on the bolts.
I figured it would be.
There it's actually been in.
It
did pull it down like a little bit, but there it just went pretty much all the way back up.
Okay. So we just gotta go past that.
Do what?
Put a scratch in the paint.
It's fine. Scratch the paint.
It's a race car.
We're gonna scratch. We're gonna scratch more of it. All race cars are show cars, Calvin.
But not all show cars are race cars.
No, definitely not. Oh yeah, let her have it. Smash that headlight bezel in.
Yeah, it got to the bezel again.
I got spare ones. See, now we bent it the other way. And then... Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, this side is now just a tad bit higher than that side.
Yeah, but I also bent the heck out of that.
No, I'm talking like the bar itself, I think.
Oh, the bar's higher?
Yeah.
That's good.
I mean, I bet if we just went over there and smashed it down with a sledge it would slide the bolts back down where they needed to be. Because it's not, it's only off by a quarter of an inch.
Yeah.
If that, maybe. I mean, I bet, dude, if you like,
I could probably stand up.
That's, yeah, that's what I was going to say. If you probably put some weight on it, it's going to go down. I mean, I'll go up there and do it. I don't think it'll fall off.
Just don't body the hood if you fall off.
How about that? Perfect, right?
Now it's too far. You're going to have to pick back up on it.
That's all you're going to get there. It's not too far, is it? Did I push it?
No, it's perfect. It's a little bit low, but it's perfect.
I'm just messing with you.
It's perfect now.
I just wanted to see you pick it back up.
It just took some Mr. Rad weight. Dude, no one's going to notice. I mean, we'll just push this thing down and you'll never know. I don't even know why we have that on there. It's aerodynamics.
Aerodynamics.
It looks cooler with that, I think.
It helps split the airflow into the radiator.
For sure. That's why my electric fan now doesn't keep myself cool while I sit here and idle, which... It kind of didn't before, but it was just snow drift, so it was cold, so it didn't really matter. Heck yeah.
What do you think? I think we're ready.
I think you just start smiling every time I turn the camera on.
It's funny
anymore. All right, the bumper's ready to rip. We just rebled the brakes. Axle, handbrake, everything's ready to rock. It honestly looks probably better than it was when we started because it's... We took more care to make it straight versus just bolting it on.
Yeah.
The last time. The last time was like, make sure this doesn't fall off and we can actually tow the car from it. Versus now it was like, we want the car to look good. You know, Body Shop Calvin putting his name on it. So, pretty stoked. We're ready for the rally. So we just finished up with our novice meeting. So basically when you're a novice in rally, you've got to sit through
4 hours because we missed the first one.
Yeah, you got to sit through 2 hours worth of learning how to rally meeting with other novices. And trust me, don't at all be like, man, this is going to suck, because this is information that you guys need to know, because we missed the first one. And just with how it's set up on a Teams meeting and stuff, you know, You really got to pay attention to your bulletins, pay attention to the supplemental regulations, pay attention to your emails, and make sure you get that on the calendar. Sit through the meeting before you go to the event, and you'll be happy you did. So we learned stuff, even sitting through it the second time, that we didn't have. Questions from Snowdrift, we were able to get answered during this meeting, which is a huge win. And if you're looking at getting into rally, it's your first time ever, 100% sit through the meeting, talk to the ARA representatives, stewards, workers, and ask them questions. Because the last thing that they want and the last thing that you want is to not have fun at the rally and to not be safe at the rally. So I'm stoked. I think we got our time card, little penalty thing where we did some math wrong, sorted out, and we're ready for 100 acre wood, yeah. Wouldn't you say?
I'm ready for it. I'm pretty excited.
What are you looking forward to the most?
Just being in the car. I want to finish this one. not breaking the car.
Calvin's looking forward to, well, one, and you guys should be looking forward to this, getting some actual driving footage of this thing. Yeah. Because so far, all the driving that we've done, or I've done, is just the back roads this past week, back past the shop. But I was texting Calvin the other night, and I was like, dude, we had one corner at Snowdrift that we just greased it perfectly. It felt so good in the car. The handbrake wasn't really working as far as like a handbrake for a rear-wheel drive. We had a parking brake for tech.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have pushed that hard on it, you know. But the handbrake now is dialed. And I had the Scandinavian flick it through the corner at Snowdrift, and we nailed it. And I've been ripping this thing this week a few times a day, and I cannot wait to finally be able to properly drive it, because it's rear-wheel drive. I've driven rear-wheel drive a lot. I've driven, not really Colts a lot, but RX-7s with a handbrake. If you remember back in the silver car days in the very beginning of the channel, my hydraulic e-brake in the silver car, dude. And that car I had no remorse for. I just beat the crap out of that car because it was rusty and beat up and like, yeah. It didn't really matter. But I pulled that handbrake.
It wasn't nearly as solid as this one is, though.
No. I pulled that handbrake so hard in the silver car that I actually broke the handle off. So we know how to drive rear-wheel drive, especially in gravel. And that's mainly what, like, the silver car and the old Supra.
Yeah.
That's what we did with it. Just terrorize gravel roads. That's been, like, it's the best. It's the most fun. So I think the car's ready. Hopefully you guys enjoyed watching this frame get fixed. I really appreciate Calvin, especially the body shop here. I know some of the guys here watch the videos for just accommodating all of our shenanigans. I know we kind of I push pretty hard, you know, with getting stuff done on pretty tight deadlines, and we work stuff in, and Calvin and I are both super busy, you know, him with work, me with all of this, plus outside work stuff, so.
And building the house.
So yeah. It gets pretty hectic. So I really, really appreciate, you know, Calvin, especially you guys watching the videos, the guys here at the body shop accommodating us, and, you know, like I said, we hose the whole place out before we leave. Always try to leave it better than you found it with everything in life. So with that, thank you guys so much for watching. I got one more video for you guys before we head off to 100 Acre Wood, but I figured I'd give you all a rally car update. It's ready to rock, and we're ready to shred some bathrooms. So thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one. Keep it rad. What, feeling that dent-free top of the fender?
See that very often.
There's a big dent right in the middle of it.
Yeah. You just can't see that with the
stripe. It just doesn't quite draw your attention, you know. Yeah. This side's pretty good though, dude. So pumped. The best part is I got a 20 mile drive back to the shop before I put this away, because I didn't really want to drive it to mom and dad's house and put it in their garage. But
to be honest, it's 1 o'clock in the morning. I would just drive it to your parents' house.
To be honest, that's probably what we'll do now. Especially since the video is over. I was going to end the video at the shop.
Yeah.
Like, successful drive back home. But I think we're just going to say, see you at the rally, and I'm going to bed. Peace, guys.